Good morning, everyone. Let's see. I've decided that during this time, I'm gonna go ahead and get my workouts straightened out. And right now, I am taking care of my morning workout, which let me get back to it in a little bit here. So, workout goals. Anyway, during the past year with COVID and everything, I did not work out whatsoever. And so I figure this is my chance here to get back to the workout regimen. So what I have been doing is basically walking, jogging, running, and at the moment I am actually on mile two. Let's see where I'm at. 2.3. So 2.25 miles into my morning workout, which is going to be 3 miles, but I figure I'd let you all know that although I've made the excuse of work and COVID affecting taking care of my fitness, there really is no excuse. 30 minutes of walking, whether it's in the yard or on a trail, it's doable. So I'm just jogging circles in my yard. I actually did a 5K, a 10K, and a half marathon in this yard, which was not fun. I missed the virtual events, but I mean, I missed the actual events. I'm not a fan of virtual. I do hope to have my first official in-person run. I think it's in either June or July. Might even be August, but it's going to be in a nearby town, and we'll see how I feel, whether or not I want to do the 5K or the 10K. But that's that. So let me go ahead and get this, let's see, a little over half a mile logged for the morning, and then I'll catch up with you later. Here's some of the video. So you get to see where my workouts actually happen. And my running partner, Oliver. Such a cheater. Cuts off. Somebody needs to move their cheap car. Anyway, I'm hating. Okay, and then we're gonna make a turn and go back towards the west, so we get to see. Okay, good morning again. I finished my 3 mile run and stretching now. I didn't always stretch, but it works. Still listening to music here, so if I try to do a Paula Deanda, that's why. Anyway, I think the music on Pop 2K reminds me of my marriage. I think about it every day, and when we've moved on, it gets so hard to walk away. Walk away. Just walk away. Especially if it's not healthy for you. So, obviously, that was Paula DeAnda with Walk Away. And, let's see. What can I say? Maybe, let me get this out of my ear for a minute. Finished my 3-mile workout, walk, jog, run, and I'll probably do another one this afternoon just because I have the time. Sitting on the back patio, basically stretching, cooling down, gonna do some crunches here in a bit. I really need to get probably a stand for my camera so you can watch me. There's Duke. Oh, and there goes Oliver. My hair is coming down from my jog and everything, but this will be my new hairstyle. For my time home. Like I said, I'm going to be on a road back to my fitness journey in these next 10 days or so. I'll bring you along. Right now I'm just gonna do regular crunches, and maybe I'll only do 20, 25 of those. I'm in very poor shape. I will do a weigh-in later and we'll see if I can get my BMI and my metabolic age and everything. It's probably really bad. I just turned 38, so if I am in my early 30s, I'll be happy with it. If I am 38 metabolically, I will be very disappointed. So, let me get these crunches in and then get you on over to my weigh-in and all of that good stuff. But anyway, we'll talk to you later. Let's see if this works. So, this is how I'm laying. Okay, so what we're doing is we're working on the glutes here. Isolation workout. Doesn't look like it works, doesn't look like it's hard, but I guarantee you, try it. Put your leg at a 90 degree angle and lift up. You'll feel it right in here. If you don't feel it in your glute and you're starting to feel it in your thighs, you're doing it wrong. Concentrate on your glute muscle. Okay, let's talk about glutes and how they are very important to us. So I actually had an injury, and it was so strange because I felt like it was in my knee. And then I want to say it moved from my knee area to like my inner thighs. And where they narrowed the problem to was actually my glutes. So obviously if you've been doing something for a while, you're able to compensate, and figure out a way to compensate, and your body's always going to want to revert to doing something easier than something harder. So the little exercise that we just did there, it was something that I did to basically fire those muscles in my glutes. Oddly enough, you know, I'm not somebody who studies the human body, the muscles in our body, but it really made running less painful for me. And so a good little quick workout, and you know, I just do three sets of five on each side. And so just figured I'd show you that little workout, and it really is helpful, and you can definitely feel it after day one of doing it. So try it out. Let me know what you think. Oh yeah, he is. Okay. Welcome to Coffee, Boba and Conversations with Mason and me. So, this video camera.
Where are you going to post this?
This is gonna be on my, I don't know, maybe my Facebook, maybe my YouTube. So, we'll put it right there in between the both of us. We're having a conversation, and I was telling Mason that I was listening to Pop 2K this morning, and all of the songs that were the top five songs, I believe it started with Alicia Keys, and then down to Usher, Mario Lyons, somebody else, and then Usher again with Yeah, reminded me of my marriage. And so Mason had some comments that I wanted to capture on video. First of all, about my first date.
He took you to a pizza place.
And
did
I don't.
Do you even like the pizza?
I don't like Pizza Hut pizza.
Wait, you went to Pizza Hut?
Yeah.
Okay, that's bad. And then he ate pizza with a fork. You should have known he was mad when he ate pizza with a fork.
Why?
There
are issues with people who eat pizza with a fork?
Yes, my sister just used her tooth as an excuse to eat pizza with a fork.
Are those people unstable? Is there statistics backing this claim up?
I don't like people eating pizza with a fork. To me, it's a sin.
It's a sin.
To me, it is.
It's just not normal.
It's not a real sin, but
so
I don't. It's not normal to me where I just eat pizza with my hands.
How many of you out there eat pizza with a fork, or do you all go to?
I know there's
grabbing
other,
it with your hands.
I know that some other people do use forks.
But not natives.
Some natives probably do.
It's just uncommon for you. Is that why you don't like it?
Yeah, hold on.
So, we are starting day two
of our quarantine.
And we're all still alive. We haven't murdered each other.
Why would you say that?
Because we haven't gotten on each other's nerves.
Kanoa gets on my nerve.
Kanoa gets on your nerves? What does he do to get on your nerves? Maybe we can fix it.
Whenever him and my sister wanna play a game, he keep bothering me. And my sister gets on my nerves too for the exact same reason.
Oh.
Even though I say no, she keeps asking, can we play, can we play, can we play, can we play, can we play? And it starts to get annoying.
If you're not already following Mason on his YouTube channel, you should definitely subscribe. He has some video game content from what I understand.
I have one.
Hungry Shark Evolution.
Yes.
Yep.
Following the Dark Hammer. And I have some.
The Dark Hammer looks like a shark that's on steroids.
But anyways,
his upper body is like so huge.
In the game, it is not stronger than the Dunkleosteus, but it is stronger than the Megalodon. I have almost all the sharks on my Kindle, but I'm not sure how to do that. It gave me the choice to go into my phone account, which is what I record videos on, and my actually and my old account that has almost all the sharks. I only have a few sharks on my new account, and I don't have one shark on my old account, the Kraken.
Okay, so again, follow Mason on his YouTube channel. I believe if you put in the search bar Mason Dalton and look for the picture
Sub-Zero and Scorpion Mortal Kombat logo. I changed my logo of my channel.
Your profile picture?
Yeah, my profile picture to the Mortal Kombat poster.
Oh, okay.
Since I like Mortal Kombat.
I'm surprised it wasn't the Godzilla versus Kong.
No, my Discord profile picture is already that.
Oh. So I guess he's on Discord too. Keep everything PG-13, please. My nephew is only 10? Yes. I'm going to take that as a yes.
One of Kanoa's friends when we were playing went from PG to rated R.
Oh, wow. And if you have any comments on what kind of hairstyle this kid should rock, drop them in the comments below. We will definitely take a vote on them. I honestly think he doesn't like his hairstyle, but
I don't trust my mom that much to do my haircut anymore because the first time she did it, she cut it in an Asian haircut and I hated it because I don't watch Asian movies and I didn't like it.
Anyway.
But then when I combed it down, it looked okay. And then the second time when my mom cut it flat, she was supposed to, she cut it upwards, like slightly upwards.
Yeah. Anyway, if you'd like us to do a duet in our next video, please let us know. Mason and I can definitely do what is that song on The Greatest Showman?
No.
What is it called though?
No.
Rewrite the Stars. Comment below if you want to hear it here. I'll get Mason to do it. Stop. This channel is PG-13. Don't be doing things like that. Remember to always follow me. And Mason. Do you want to sing a verse of something? No?
All right, this is getting weird.
Okay, bye.
Bye.